is a six-time winner of the Quit Forest Rally. You're very well credentialed to comment and give us some insights to this event and what it actually takes to win here.
Look, it takes a lot. I came over here for the very first time as a cocky young bloke in 1990, and I think I went off the road about three times all up in the event. And, you know, it's very different to the rest of Australia. It's, you know, the ball bearing gravel is incredibly slippery and they're very technical roads. So, you know, in the early days it wasn't pace noted, which made it even harder, but it's slippery, it's very technical. It's hard to pull up, particularly when you're going downhill. And, you know, we saw by the carnage yesterday, there's a lot of people making mistakes, and that's just the nature of the roads over here for people learning it.
Tell us what that means. Our series obviously made up of outright with some really fast front-wheel drive cars, of course, four-wheel drive cars. Your classic Celica here is rear-wheel drive. Tell us the challenges of each of those categories, in your opinion, on what each person has to try and deal with there.
Well, if you're in two-wheel drive, front-wheel drive, obviously uphill traction's a real problem because, the weight's leaning back, taking it off the front wheels. In a rear-wheel drive car, two-wheel drive car, it's difficult to stay on the line because the front-wheel drive cars drive with the front wheels, so they've got their line on the road, and I'm hanging outside that all the time, so you struggle for grip. And the four-wheel drive cars, while they have incredibly good traction, as you well know, they rocket out of corners, but they're also very heavy. So to pull them up going downhill is hard work. So each of the different types of cars have got their strengths and weaknesses, and they all take a different driving style.
And therefore the road almost evolves as we do a second pass. A lot of the stages we repeat. And as you say, the line sometimes changes from the first time. And if you're at the pointy end of the field, it's very loose. It changes the feel to it the next time around, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. When we repeated Koala and Ferndale yesterday, we were going over a second a kilometre faster. And, that's a very, very big difference. And thanks to the Western Australian State guys as well. They'd made the road wider and more swept. And, like I was car 10, but there was one very single line. Yes. When we came back around for the second run, there was a nice wide line and you could use all the road.
Now, you touched on Ferndale there and carnage as well. That particular stage seems to be infamous in our series for drivers that catches out whether you're very experienced or whether you're a newbie to the sport. What is it about that stage yesterday that catches so many people year after year?
Look, it's got a lot of different speeds. Like, it's got some incredibly fast sections and then it turns off into some incredibly tight sections. It's got a lot of steep downhill, a lot of steep uphill. So, people, when they're going uphill, get really confident, then it starts heading downhill and all of a sudden they brake too late. And, and it takes some adjustment to go from really fast stuff back into the tight stuff. So, because it's got such an enormous amount of variation in the road terrain, it makes it harder for people to manage.
Well, definitely caught plenty out. Mate, you still got three stages to go. You have an absolute ball in your machine. Thanks for the insight there, mate, and we'll look forward to catching up at the finish.
Thanks, Ed. I thought it was only two, but I better go and have a look.
No, no. Rewrite, get the glasses out, mate.
Rewrite it.